that it even defeats the purpose.
But you can there are some information that are available already. What time it was? Mm-hmm. So all you have to do now is trace it back.
Trace it back.
Yeah, trace it back. At what time it was detonated, etc. Uh-huh. And then what are the calls that goes into that area? Then you trace it back.
Okay. Now you're speaking technically here, because there are cell sites, obviously, no?
Yes.
So in
yes.
a particular cell site, you can monitor what calls are being made through that cell site.
The numbers that are the caller mm-hmm. the calling number and the call number are
in that area at that particular time.
Yes.
And you can narrow it down to yes. that particular yes. area, say for the Batasan.
Yes.
You can narrow where the call was received to detonate that bomb.
That's correct. So if they are
the police ask the NTC to do that?
But the numbers are not registered. The owners are not registered.
So they're not monitored at all.
They're still a blank wall.
So if it were a postpaid line, for example, kung ganun
it would be easier.
Yes. If they had used a postpaid line to trigger the bomb that killed Congressman Nakbar, it would have been easier to trace.
It would have been easier. Yes.
So parang ganun ang feasibly pwedeng mangyari if prepaid cards were registered. The NTC can help.
The good congressman is in fact pointing out that this may not be a foolproof.
Well, yeah. Well,
antidote against threats to public safety, but this may minimize. That is why we are willing to sit with the congressman and trace out possible solutions to certain concerns.
Yeah. Well, first of all, you have a worry that it's going to strain your database capability a lot, and also you're thinking that a lot of people don't have valid IDs to register their real identities anyway. So a lot of these questions can't be resolved.
Earlier, there were talks in the lower house in say that, as pointed out by Congressman Rodriguez, almost all the subscribers are in the barrio.
Yeah.
And there perhaps could be a certification by the barangay captain as testing to the fact that this person is really that person accompanied by a picture. That might be one of those which we may consider. But even as we talked, I voiced out to Congressman Rodriguez the fact that starting with the registration of the 75 to 80 is massive.
Massive.
It is difficult. Yeah. It is more than just election registration.
Yeah.
Perhaps we can act on this bill prospectively.
Okay.
And slowly, perhaps we can find a solution.
I think in other countries that have already mandated SIM card registration, they're doing it on a staggered basis.
Yes.
So especially like China, which are so many, I guess, more cell phone users in China than in the Philippines, that they have to do it on a staggered basis.
Yes.
So the telcos have somehow, sort of mellowed out on your resistance.
Tony, we have concerns precisely about the gargantuan tasks of implementing this, because the bill proposed by my good friend Congressman Rodriguez has penalties. It says fine and in the end or and imprisonment on the corporation or certain responsible officers of the corporation. That's why I said let us talk and let us stress out certain concerns, and once we solve this problem, then we are more than willing to help.
But from the technical side, NTC, it can be a useful tool.
It can be,
to trace criminal activities.
Yes.
Okay. Pero na lang akong sumabog na yung buong device at wala ka nang magamit na forensic evidence to trace anything. I mean, even a registered SIM, when it's destroyed.
No, the caller. The one that...
The caller?
Yeah, the caller.
Ah,
so you trace it back.
So trace it back. Yeah. Okay. So yun ang hahanapin natin ngayon.
Yes, hahanapin diba? Yung caller.
Okay. So pwede mong i-backtrace who sent the call to the detonator.
Yes.
If everything was registered.
By elimination.
Okay. Ito naman ang sabi ng mga devil's advocates. And I'm really having fun reading all of these comments that say, it can't be done. Kung hindi daw cellphone ang gagamitin na pang-detonate, they'll find other ways to detonate it remotely. Sa NTC po ba, apart from cellphones, what other radio devices can be used to detonate? Well, sorry, I'm not giving clues to anybody who'd want to do it. Para lang we'll just be sure, no? Parang sabihin nila, you eliminated the cell phone as a triggering device, they'll look for other ways to trigger a bomb remotely. NTC, what does it say?
Well, all radio stations are registered with the NTC.
So what does that mean? Mr. DJ, can you play this song? Yung pala, yun ang pang-detonate. Hindi, I'm just kidding.
Hindi,
so ano po yung radio na device that they can use to detonate a bomb kung hindi po siya cellphone?
Well, kung meron man yan, it would be specially designed for that, and that would be very expensive.
Very expensive.
Hindi siya commercially available.
Okay. Merong special device na ganun?
There may be.
My other concern, Tony, here is the registration, if it comes to pass, may be very good in preventing petty crimes.
Petty.
But, yeah, but this is our, what are percolating in my thoughts right now. But for a hardened criminal, why will he produce or establish his own evidence against himself?
So something that can be traceable.
We have to face this reality.
So you're making it difficult for the criminal. Sabi nga ni Congressman Rodriguez, no, yung pakikitirin mo lang yung avenues of activities that they can use to perpetrate their crimes. Pakikitirin mo, but you can't absolutely close it. Is that good enough, do you think? Pakitirin mo man lang, pero you're still, you know, there's a slim possibility may iba silang gagawin.
Well, minimizing it may be a good problem.
Yeah.
Maybe a good solution.
And yet other people say, but the cost and the resources of minimizing is, you know, parang too much.
Iyon nga, because some wise guy also said we may be burning the entire house just to get rid of a small rat. I do not know, but that is why we said let us talk. Let everybody face each other on a workshop on the and then let us discuss.
But you know, I don't think your thoughts have been percolating on the show only. You must have been percolating many years ago, di ba?
Yeah.
By now, fully brewed na yung kape sa pagka-percolate.
No, but I understand the purpose of, and I have no quarrel about the purpose.
Yeah.
Public safety. Who can argue against public safety?
Sure.
But the issue here is the means with which we want to achieve the purpose.
Oh,
so let us talk on the means.
Is there a way to block cell phone trigger devices by Director, apart from jamming all the signals in that area?
You can block the SIM card.
Yun lang.
They can choose.
But you'll have to know which SIM card to block.
That's
muna.
That's
okay. You have to anticipate beforehand.
Kailangan meron kang Bureau of Future Crimes parang kay Tom Cruise sa Minority Report. But what I mean is, you know, people think that you can detonate a device by a radio signal, right?
Any
radio signal.
Yes.
So it can be a cell phone, could be anything.
Yes.
But you can block that technically, right?
You can block if you know the frequencies.
Kasi parang iniisip ng tao parang sa ibang mga sensitive installations. Pagpasok mo doon, walang signal yung phone mo.
Yeah,
so block na agad
jam.
So it's jamming lang within the site itself.
Okay. Within the site.
Pero for NTC to jam the signals lahat, hindi kaya, syempre.
You block everything.
You block the entire spectrum. You block everybody.
You block everybody. That's not feasible.
Para ka magiging Egypt nun. Yeah, well, Egypt has a lot of other problems, hindi lang cell phone bombs. So telcos willing to sit down, sabi ni Congressman Rufus Rodriguez, 2 weeks from now, they're going to have some hearings. You have to have some workable solutions already, right? Kayo po ba ang magpresent ng solutions, or you expect the congressman to be the ones to present?
No, in fact, in my earlier talk with the congressman before your show, we're talking about providing a staggering of a solution.
Staggered solution?
Staggered solution, because I said we simply cannot all at the same time register the 75 million prepaid subscribers.
How long do you think it will take to register 75 million?
I do not know, because in election registration, where on a cumulative basis we just register new voters, it takes really a hell of a time.
Yeah. And
manpower.
Manpower, okay. Who's going to handle the registration? Sabi ni Congressman Rodriguez, you buy a SIM card, you register where you bought it, and then whoever delivered it will pick up the information and bring it back to your head office. Is that workable?
The sellers, but please note that as far as the telcos are concerned, our presence are only in the urban areas.
Okay.
These SIM cards reaches the remote rural areas via these retailers and the sub-retailers and into the sari-sari store, over which we lose control.
Doon.
Doon. Otherwise, if it is the telcos will be the one to register, then SIM cards can be bought only in our centers.
Sa outlets niyo.
And in a sense, it negates universal access to universal service. Because now it would be difficult really to obtain a communication system or service, because they can be available, the SIMs can only be available in those places where we have the centers.
And of course, the telcos, from a marketing point of view, won't agree to that, because that's going to eat up your revenues naman.
Medyo bababa yan. But again, when we give it to our retailers, we have to be sure that our retailers are competent enough to comply with the law.
Okay. Can NTC help with that?
I think so. We can help. No, we can help. Well, there are only very few SIM card holders outside metropolitan areas.
Outside of metropolitan areas?
Yes.
Very
yes.
few?
Very few. If you compare it, if you get the data, okay. most of these SIM card users are
in the urban areas.
Urban areas and suburban areas, but only few are there. So what can be done perhaps is get a day or two or 1 week and go in this area with
campaign.
Telcos there, campaign for the registration.
And then you're talking about new SIM card subscribers. So what about the existing base of prepaid? What are you going to do with them?
For existing. There to the area. With the telcos with you, and then campaign for the registration.
But so the problem there, Tony, is it is not really realistic to say that we just go to that area and everybody will be there. Because majority of the subscribers are, say, in the hinterlands of Mindanao, the caimiros or the farm workers of Baguio. They don't have the means to go to the city
travel.
For purposes. They even have a hard time buying loads. And here we are requiring them to come to the city and have yourself registered. That's the problem there.
Because my manager has said, if you don't register,
we will block you. What happens now to these poor folks whose only means of communication is this, given the fact that they would not even travel, because this is less expensive than traveling.
So may mga social aspect then that
there are concerns. There are the retailers, they will lose business, the sari-sari stores. And if on the other hand we are authorized to again resell our SIM cards to the retailers, who is now responsible, us or the sari-sari stores?
Okay, well, sistema lang po ang kailangan
siguro. System, sistema.
It's a system that has to be designed, a system that has to be practical and fair for everybody. And also, siguro, realistic. No? Because kung ang end point is to prevent crime, hindi dapat talaga, there is a deterrent in it. Pero kung malulusutan, then it might all be for nothing. No? Problema. I can see you percolating more ideas.
I'd like to help my good friend, Congressman Rodriguez.
I'm sure you will. Congressman Rufus, I'm sure he'll always be open to any ideas, especially now that the telcos seem to be a little bit more cooperative.
That's a good observation,
yes,
Tony.
All right. Well, thank you very much, gentlemen, for coming to the show. Attorney Rodolfo Salalima and Engineer Edgardo Cabarrios of the NTC. Suki na po natin si Engineer Cabarrios. Basta may mga issue ganito, I can always count on you to be here. Thanks very much,
thank you, both of you, for coming.
Thank you, Tony.
Well, coming up, do electromagnetic fields of power lines pose a health risk to nearby residents? We look back at a case filed in Makati when Future Perfect returns.